inspiration. Goes behind Deva Sahaya. Goes after a particular episode in the Travancore history, which has layers of meaning. The theme that he has chosen for this work reveals more of Gopi Krishna, if not more, at least as much as the book reveals the mind of Mata Gavarma or Nallamunde. Because an author chooses a topic or a theme, because the theme has affected him in some way, the author becomes restless with a particular theme. Otherwise, nobody will undertake to write something, because writing is no easy job. It is no fun to write, particularly a play like this, fairly long play, or even to write a poem on a particular theme. Nobody will undertake unless that theme becomes so dear to you or so disturbing to you that unless you write, you will die. You get that kind of a feeling. Now, I am fascinated by Gopi Krishna's mind, which became restless by this particular theme, which has today layers and layers of meaning, texts and subtexts, which I do not want to go into because I do not want to talk about karmaprasi and all that ultimately might lead there. I do not want to talk about such things, but basically it is about conversion. Wonderful thing is that the author does not take any sides. That is a hallmark of a great poet. Of course, we may have sides, we may have sympathies and empathies, but the work does not portray somebody as good or somebody as bad. There is no clear-cut villains and heroes. Rather, there are heroic traits in every character. Whether it is Deva Sahaya, also known as Nallapulle, or Nallapulle, also known as Deva Sahaya, Illinois, or the king himself, except of course Ramayan, who goes and stabs the. But Ramayan also is driven by loyalty. He is also value driven, but his own set of values. Ramayan also is heavily value driven. You may not approve of his values, but he is nevertheless driven by values of loyalty. In the war, you kill hundreds of people, but when you commit a murder of a captain or a soldier or a leader, captain, what is it? Commander of the umbrella of the triangle of forces, you cannot suddenly say that it is bad. In what way? He is also driven by set of values. Another point I would like to say is this: the way the king has been portrayed. Martanda Varma is a very, it's a very complex character. Maybe history has not come to terms with this, the complexity of his character. Especially Kerala history, the way it is written, with little bit of scorn about the Travancore, the royal period, because we have to be socialists and progressive, so we should not be saying good things about the kings. I think we have been extremely partial in our assessment of the royal history of Travancore. Even C.V. Ramanpillai, I don't think he has done justice to Martanda Varma. He has done justice to Ananda Vakmanabhan and so many others, not to Martanda Varma. I don't want to be quoted. But I think C.V. ought to have been more sympathetic to Martanda Varma, especially when he was writing a novel under that title. But I think Gopi Krishna has been extremely understanding of Martanda Varma, his greatness, his weakness, his loneliness, his compulsions, and his compassions. Not even once he sort of betrays that kind of, you know, when people say a lot of bad things about Deva Sahaya, he is not fully convinced. Although he decreed a lot of things, but he never mentally gave him up. He never doubted his loyalty. That is one thing. And going into the mind of Deva Sahaya himself, I think for every conversion, there is a pull factor and a push factor. According to the political party or the political side that you favor, you might see push factor or pull factor. But only when at the intersection of the pull factor and the push factor, conversion takes place. Here, the kind of social situation that prevailed in those times, which a sensitive person like Nallamunda could not agree, That explains the push factor. Pull factor is also there. So that is again, that again shows the balancing act, or rather the comprehension of a poet. He is not partisan, but he only tries to understand, empathetically understand, imaginatively understand the truth of a situation. That is why both the push factor and the pull factor have been adequately represented in the conversion. Now, I don't think that this work is going to create a stir about the conversion and all the history of it, but like any great book, this book should definitely persuade us to look at an episode in history with the wisdom of hindsight and reappraise our villains and heroes with more imaginative empathy. That's all I would like to say. Gopi Krishnan has presented before us a wonderful piece of writing with an intensity that he alone can command, and with a simplicity that only a seasoned poet can master. Because poets deal with words in a particular fashion, not like a novelist. I'm not saying that novelists are not good with words. But a poet cannot, does not have the liberty to use 250 pages. He has to write something in 2.5 pages. That's it. So he has to be very economical with words. Therefore, every poet condenses. Unless the condensation is there, it is no good poetry. It cannot be poetry. If you are just explaining everything, like in olden times, when our poets used to write letters in Malayalam, Kathagetti, Kathagetti, Kairingrihichunyan, Muthu Bole, Dalinamanasa. There is no poetry in it. I got your letter, I am very happy, that's it. You don't have to write poetry to convey these things. Now, real poetry condenses. Real poetry condenses feelings and emotions and facts in such a way that nobody else can do it. The poet will use images for that. He will use all kinds of tricks. And Gopi Krishnan is a past master with his words in English. And his words, the dialogues are so simple. But the instructions and all those settings are given in chaste English. I was extremely happy to read such excellent English. We Malayalis, or like for that matter anybody with a different linguistic background, is invariably influenced by our own mother tongue. And to overcome it, like getting away from the gravity of Earth, is not an easy thing. It is like getting away from Earth's gravity. Or the ISRO scientists, if somebody is there, they know that the biggest problem is to get away from the gravity of Earth, because it pulls. Likewise, your mother tongue always pulls you towards it, and affects your accent, affects your thinking, affects your syntax. Everything affects your, even your poetic images are affected. Affected not in a bad way, not in a negative way. It does influence. But if you have to retain the flavor of English, you have to make a conscious effort. That is where I think our education suffers from a conscious effort to speak good English. I am Vice Chancellor of Malayalam University. I am speaking in English. I'm not ashamed of it. I've never said that never study English. I have only said and will continue to say till I die that in order to study English, it is foolish to say and believe that you should forget Malayalam and you should not learn Malayalam. That attitude you cannot encourage. Just because you know Malayalam, it doesn't mean that you will not know English. Our parents somehow feel that my child has to study English medium LKG so that he becomes a great scholar in English. The fellow doesn't grow either in Malayalam or in English. His Malayalam is bad, therefore his English is bad. Because it has been taught by a teacher whose English is pathetic. Therefore, naturally, LKG, who teaches English? Is it an MA English teacher who goes and teaches? Somebody tries to struggle with a poor English. What can she do? So the child becomes extremely restricted in expression. So that affects his Malayalam. Because that affects his Malayalam, his linguistic skills are compromised. And he never becomes good either in English or Malayalam. That is precisely the problem of language education in Kerala. Therefore, I am not against English education. We should all try to speak English as English, and Gopi Krishnan knows how to use English as an Englishman does. That is the beauty of the language, and that ensures that this work will travel far. Let it travel towards the west, let it travel towards the east. Let it conquer the east and the west and all those people who love the art of poetry and the art of drama. I'm sure sooner than later, a thoughtful producer shall approach you to make a wonderful film on Martha. Thank you very much. I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much, sir. Now I invite our regional director of the Reserve Bank of India, Trivandrum, Sri Nirmal Chand, sir, to speak a few words.
Sri Jay Kumar, retired chief secretary and currently vice chancellor. Sri Adhikeshan, chief general manager, State Bank of Travancore. C.K. Thomas, Deputy Director, Doordarshan. Shri M. Devi Prasad, GM, State Bank of Travancore. Ladies and gentlemen, a bright moment for entire RBI fraternity and me personally, that today I'm a part of this ceremony on the book launch is titled The Nectar of Ghosts, a play written by our own Deputy General Manager Shri Gopi Krishan from RBI Trivandrum. I just gathered that he has written 8 books of poetry, 3 novels and 4 plays, besides poems and articles in various magazines. Some of the poems and articles I happened to read, which came through our own house magazines, like English and Malayalam. He is equally proficient in Hindi also, because he has been subscribing to our own in-house journal, that is Umang. One thing, you know, I remember that when I was in college and school, I used to be the editor of our school and college magazine. I used to write, you know, some articles or poems also. But when I got this job, and I totally, you know, got cut off from writing. And Gopi Krishan, he continued writing. We know that despite, you know, attending these long hours, working hours in RBI, it becomes very difficult to pursue your hobby or passion, I would say. And particularly after becoming a senior officer, it is all the more difficult to find time. He could carve out time, probably, which belonged to his family. And I must compliment family members for supporting him and, of course, bringing all of us together here on this occasion. Another thing I want to say that we need good writers like Gopal Krishan today, so that their books are able to attract particularly the new generation towards books, reading books, and reducing the time they are spending in front of television or computers, which may prove health hazard in the long run. No one can be a better friend than a good book. We need to keep this generation in the company of good books. His books have been the mirror of the society. I'm sure that all of us will enjoy reading this play also. And I am sure that we will get to read many more such books from Shri Gopal Krishna in future also. Now one more thing which I want to say here, like Reserve Bank of India also promote the talent which our staff members do possess in the field of economics, research, statistics, banking, and there are certain schemes for pursuing these careers, but probably no one has thought of that if someone has the flair for writing, whether we can promote these kind of talents. A few days back in our office, we had a book review, and we started with a book from Munshi Premchand, and that was the beginning, and we said that the Trivandrum office is reading a book on Munshi Premchand, because as I said that these books, particularly who write about the society, so in the long run also people will come to know that what was happening during that period. And I think this is one such example.